Okay, if you like this video, subscribe to my channel. But let's get right to it. So I was never a big fan of the arrival scene of Arnold Schwarzenegger in Terminator 3 Rise of the Machines. You know, it was so raw in the first film. The second film, they finessed it really, really well. And they kind of showed the, you know, a little bit of the orb that kind of sliced the truck and then indented the ground underneath Arnold. But I feel like every time they were doing a sequel, they were trying to outdo what they did before with the entrance. And this particular sequence with Arnold, when he shows up, looks clearly done on a soundstage with a full wraparound cyclorama. And obviously, you know, he was 55 years old when he did Terminator 3. And he put back on all the muscle, but, you know, I don't think his midsection was defined because of how the camera panned around him as he rises and then ends up, you know, just above his pecs here, you know, or below his pecs here. You know, 55 years old, he was still in amazing shape doing this film. And this was the last movie before he became governor. So I think he really thought he was going out on a high note and that his political career would take off, which is why I think it was a very ballsy ending of the film to have the Terminator have all the nukes fall and then basically start future war. But let's take a look at the original edit here. And I'll tell you what I didn't like about it and why I decided to recut it for myself and just do a little bit of a fan edit. We'll go back to the beginning here and we'll play. Yeah, definitely a soundstage. The rattlesnake, for me, just didn't do anything for me. Yeah, it was kind of cool the way it pushed in, but in the end, I just didn't. It was like, why? You could have just started here. And again, you know, with the sphere, you know, it has the like a grid on it now, and it melts away kind of, and the grid dissolves, and I don't know. I don't know why they felt the need to do something like this with the sphere. The music didn't do anything for me either. I just thought, eh, give us the classic Terminator music, you know. Give us the perfect Terminator music from the first film. I didn't mind the melted sand underneath. I thought that was kind of cool, and it breaks like glass as he walks. You know, but then the scene just cuts and it goes to this the whole pet scene with you know, John Connor and getting the phenobarbital and all that with the drugs, and I thought it really just broke up the pace of it. So I want to jump a little bit to the next scene here. No real music except that high pitch. Just nothing. It just didn't do anything for me. Now, this particular actor played Roscoe Picotrain in the Dukes of Hazzard movie that had Sean William Scott in it and Willie Nelson and Johnny Knoxville. And this was the first time I think I'd ever seen him as an actor, and it was just like this one line scene here. And I thought he did a good job.
You're supposed to go around to the back.
But in the end, you know, for my version, I just felt he should just walk up and then, hey, you know, this just killed it for me. That really fast head whip to the ladies' night. And then of course the stripper comes out and it's another one of those, this kind of stuff I didn't mind. And I actually don't mind the song here. but when they switch it up to Macho Man from the Village People, and his head whips right there, that killed it for me, killed the scene for me. And you know, the motorcycle guy's got the outfit on and he's dancing, and the one thing that always frustrated me with the Terminator Rise of the Machines was at this point, they had just gotten so campy with the comedy in it. I just thought it was weird because in the end, he's a Terminator. Terminator. And to have him just constantly cracking jokes, talk to the hand, you know, all this kind of stuff that was in the film, I just thought, you know, if you just cut out all the comedy, it would be a really, you know, darker film in general.
Take off your clothes.
Patience, honey.
Yeah, man. I mean, can you imagine throwing a glove in a Terminator's face? Like, you don't, I mean, in the end, that Terminator should have just killed him, you know, ripped his heart out or something and just take his outfit, you know, because in the end, this Terminator is not there. He's been programmed to protect, you know, but, you know, no one's telling this guy not to kill people. And I just thought, what a slap in the face. The girls jump up. Everybody gets happy because he's... Yeah.
Now.
Yeah. Just. Although the girl in the pink outfit with the cowboy hat was hot. And here, you know, once again, you know, he reaches into his jacket and he pulls out those horrible Elton John kind of sunglasses. And I thought, why? Like, why go there with the movie and slow the pace to get this laugh? And he steps on him, oh, because they're not the ones I want. And then, of course, the classic Terminator comes in here, you know, tears up the car, you know, hotwires it, peels off, puts the right sunglasses on. Now he's good to go. Now he's ready to go. And for me, I just, I needed something else with this. And anyway, so let's just get to my version of the scene, edit it down so you can kind of see what I did, and I'll walk you through it. Okay, so this is my cut of the arrival scene. And right off the bat, you'll see a difference. It's faster. The pace is a little faster because I cut out the snake.
What the hell?
All right, so obviously it's a lot tighter. I got rid of all the comedy that was in it. And what's really cool is, you know, when Arnold finally rises up here, I did for pacing just get rid of the stepping on the molten glass sand and skip right to the next truck scene. But I even took out the truck because, again, it's like it was such a weird transition. And I put the original Terminator music in there from T1. So when he walks up and you hear this, this is the T1 music. And again, like I felt like, you know, the door guy, his line didn't do anything, you know, for the film. I mean, he's kind of consumed playing his crossword puzzle. And I was like, he's oblivious that Arnold is standing there completely naked until he looks up and says, "Hey, you need to go in the back door." Now, this guy's been probably bouncing a long time, clubs and bars. And if you saw a naked guy walk up, would you really think he's one of the Chippendales that's showing up completely naked and walking through the front door? It just didn't make sense to me. So for me, him just looking up and being startled that there's like some dude there and he gets up to stop him, but boom, he just slams the door open on him. As we see here.
What the hell?
And of course I needed an incidental there. So I took my sound design, did a little bit with a new hit from the door. And I was the guy, you know, that threw in the line, "What the?" Just before he gets hit. The song that's in here, if you guys remember from Terminator 1, in Tech Noir, the bar, this is the song. When Arnold first is looking for Sarah Connor, and that dream, almost that dream sequence, slow motion, as you know, he's walking by and she drops the glass and bends over to get the glass and Arnold passes by. Just a classic scene. And I really like that song. I've seen a couple of other fan edits where they've put in, the song, "It's a mistake. It's a mistake. Nah, nah, nah." And that's the one, you know, Sarah's roommate was playing that on the headphones when she got killed. At the, you know, "It's a mistake," you know, such a, you know, nice throw in there, because it wasn't the right Sarah Connor in the first Terminator film. And I like that song and I thought it worked well in another fan edit, but I thought I just wanted for mine to throw it in there. You know, I didn't like the idea of the Terminator getting punked out and having that glove thrown in his face. And I thought, okay, he finds the guy, you see the match, and then he steps out and the guy's closed. And you can only assume that he just took them. And obviously I cut out the glasses, the joke with the glasses. I just hated that, with the Elton John glasses. It just didn't work for me, man. The movie as a whole I thought was really good. And compared to Genesis and Dark Fate, I think this is a better film, and it's been kind of maligned, if you will. But I think in retrospect, it's actually not a bad Terminator film to be the third in the trilogy, especially the way it ends with Arnold completely destroyed and the T-800's face in the ash. So anyway, that was my cut of the arrival scene for Terminator 3 Rise of the Machines. I hope you enjoyed this video, and we'll see you on the next one.